In 2 Corinthians chapter 11, Paul warns the Corinthian Christians against being deceived. And I suppose we'd all agree, if anybody was charismatic, they were. So being charismatic doesn't grant you an exemption. Paul says in verse 3 of 2 Corinthians 11, "But I fear lest somehow, as the serpent deceived Eve by his craftiness, so your minds may be corrupted from the simplicity and purity that is in Christ. For if he who comes, another preacher, preaches another Jesus, whom we have not preached, or if you receive a different spirit, which you have not received, that is, which is not the Holy Spirit, or a different gospel, which you have not accepted, you may well put up with it." Isn't it amazing how ready people are to accept the false? And notice, if you have another Jesus, you'll have a different spirit and a different gospel. So any presentation of Jesus that is not scriptural, that is not in line with scripture, will be accompanied by a different spirit, which is not the Holy Spirit. And the result will be a gospel which is not the true gospel. There are currently in the church today various different versions of another Jesus. I'll just mention three. There's Jesus, the Marxist revolutionary, who's going to go out with a machine gun and fight on behalf of the poor and liberate the poor from the oppressor. Now, that's very popular in South America, but also in other places. But that's not the Jesus of the Bible. He is not like that. It's very praiseworthy to want to help the poor, but not that way. That's not the believer's way to help the poor. That is called liberation theology. Very acceptable in many parts of the world, inside the church. In Latin America, there are many Catholics who've embraced liberation theology and sometimes align themselves with Marxist movements. Then there's Jesus, the Oriental Guru. And people proudly trace him back to Buddha and Socrates and all that sort of thing. The kind of movement that does that is what we call today the New Age movement. They kind of get Jesus lined up with a lot of other gurus. But he's not a guru. He's the Son of God. He's the Savior. And that is a false gospel. And it is accompanied by another spirit. And then there's Jesus, the kindly Father Christmas, who wanders around patting everybody on the head and saying, "There, there, don't worry." That is what I call the liberal church. It has a Jesus that doesn't speak about sin, never mentions judgment, and says all religions are different roads to the same God. Here, there, there, don't worry, there's nothing to be afraid of. So there's three examples of contemporary teaching which introduce deception by bringing on another Jesus. And I would say the number of people currently deceived by one or other of those numbers the millions. So it's not just a little fringe group somewhere.